الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
Alhamdulillah. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلوات الله وسلامه وبركاته عليه. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد فإن خير الكلام كلام الله تبارك وتعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. أيها الإخوة والأخوات، رعاكم الله تبارك وتعالى جميعا. My dear brothers and sisters in Al-Islam, may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala take care of you. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala preserve you. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala bless you and reward you for the best of your deeds that are done for His face, for the best of your deeds that are done for His sake, for the best of your deeds that are done ala mutaba'ati ar-rasul sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam. فهو خليله وصفيه وأمينه على وحيه مبلغ الناس شرعه النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. He is the close خليل of Allah تبارك وتعالى. He is the صفي of Allah سبحانه وتعالى أو مصطفى. He is the one whom Allah تبارك وتعالى has placed as an أمين over the revelation that was sent down to him from the heavens, laylan wa naharan. An-Nabiyyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ar-Rasulul Kareem, that noble messenger, that prophet of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, who was sent rahmatan lil alameen, who was sent as a mercy to all of humanity, to all of mankind, to all of jinn, bell to all of the creation in its entirety, our messenger alayhi salatu wassalam. Ayyuha al-mu'minun ibadullah, min a'zami wajibat ahli al-iman, from the most critical, from the most tremendous, from the most important of the affairs that are from the wajibat, that in obligations, that are those things that if the person does those things, he is rewarded bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. And from the things that if a person stays away from, he does not do them, he is subjected and he is deserving of the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Min a'zami wajibati ahli al-iman, from the greatest and most important of the affairs that are obligations upon the people of al-iman, you and I bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, is al-iman bihadha ar-rasul al-kareem, is belief, having the proper iman, having the proper belief system, having the proper understanding, having the proper commitment to the adherence to following this noble messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa mimma yazidu shakhsan imanan bihi, and that which will increase, that which will serve to be an incentive, that which will serve to be something that will support and aid and help and increase the individual, you and I as people of iman, and even the people who are not people of iman, that will serve to increase them in the iman of this Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, or entering into the iman of this Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, is ma'rifatu khisalihi, is understanding and having knowledge of the characteristics of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa sifatihi al-khalqiyya wal-khuluqiyya, and his descriptions, those ways that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has been described to us, whether it be his physical description or whether it be that description of his nature, of his character, of his manners, of his behavior, of his aqidah, of his ibadah, of his akhlaq, of his suluk, all of these things will serve to increase your iman in the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, provided that you have knowledge of these things. Brothers and sisters in Al-Islam, do we like to be, or do we want to be like those whom Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has mentioned in the Quran of Ahlul Kufr, of the Kuffar? Or those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned about them, أَمْ لَمْ يَعْرِفُ الرَّسُولَهُمْ فَهُمْ لَهُ مُنْكِرُونَ. Do we want to be like those whom Allah tabarak wa ta'ala mentioned in his book? Or is it, do they not know and recognize and understand their prophet who was sent to them? فَهُمْ لَهُمْ مُنْكِرُونَ. Rather, they are those who are rejecting him. Why are they rejecting him? لَوْ عَرِفُوا حَقَّهُ وَلَوْ عَرِفُوا رِسَالَتَهُ وَلَوْ عَرِفُوا خِصَالَهُ وَسُلُوكَهُ وَأَخْلَاقَهُ وَأَقِيدَتَهُ لَيُؤْمِنُوا بِهِ. If they know the manners of the Messenger of Allah, if they knew what he was sent with, if they had knowledge and understanding and ma'rifa of his characteristics, if they had knowledge of his methodology and the way that he was upon, if they had knowledge of these things, most certainly they would have believed in him. If they understood these things properly, most certainly they would have believed in him. Aisha Dalil, what is the proof of that? The hadith of Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala an, that we find narrated, that we find mentioned and collected in the Sahih of Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah ta'ala. When Abu Sufyan radiallahu ta'ala an, when Abu Sufyan went and he was summoned to the court of Huraqal, Azim al-Rum, when him and those who were with him amongst his companions, when they were in a state of kufr at that time, and they were in the company in the court of the Azim al-Rum, the emperor of Rome, the leader of Rome, an individual whom their subjects took him as an ilah min dunillah, as someone to be worshipped besides Allah. This was his status in the sight of the people. A man of a magnificent status and nature in sight of the people throughout the dunya, Azim al-Rum, Huraqal. What did he say to Abu Sufyan? He asked him about the Shama'il. He asked him about the distinct qualities and characteristics of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He asked him, what kind of family does he come from? Abu Sufyan did not lie, and he said, I could not lie because this was the way of the Arab. Even in their filth of their aqidah, even in the filth and the facade that they will cause in the earth amongst themselves, one of the things of their rujula, one of the things of their manhood, is that they still would not lie. He said he comes from the most noble of lineage, from the best of us. As we find collected in the Sahih of Imam Bukhari, as the Messenger of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala said himself, إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى مِنْ وَلَدِ إِسْمَاعِيلَ كِنَانَةً وَاصْطَفَى مِنْ كِنَانَةٍ قُرَيْشٍ وَاصْطَفَى مِنْ قُرَيْشٍ بَنِي هَاشِمٍ وَاصْطَفَانِي مِنْ بَنِي هَاشِمٍ. The Messenger of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala said that Allah Ta'ala, he chose from the offspring of Ismail Kinana, and from Kinana he chose Quraysh, and from Quraysh he chose Banu Hashim, which is the clan of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and from Banu Hashim he chose me. He said he's from the best of the people alayhi salatu wasalam. He said, was anyone from amongst his lineage kings amongst you? He said no. He said, was anyone from amongst you ever claim prophethood like this individual who's claiming prophethood? Abu Sufyan, he said, la. He said, who are those who follow him? Are they the weak from amongst the society? The poor, impoverished from amongst the society? The looked down upon ones from amongst the society? Or are they the rich? Are they the strong? Are they those who have status? He said, it is the weak from amongst us. He said, it is the weak from amongst us. He said, do you find any of the people after accepting his religion, after believing in Islam, after believing in the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after knowing the reality of his risala, do you find them leaving and abandoning Islam? He said, no, never, none of them. He said, what is it that he commands you to do? He said, he commands us to abandon the ibadatul awthan, to abandon and shun and stay away from worshiping idols. يَأْمُرُنَا بِالصَّلَاةِ. He commands us with prayer, as-salah. يَأْمُرُنَا بِالصِّدْقِ. يَأْمُرُنَا بِالْأَثَافِ. He commands us to be truthful. He commands us to be modest. He commands us to guard our chastity. وَيَأْمُرُنَا بِالْبِرُّ وَالِدَيْنِ. And he commands us to honor and respect our parents and those مِنْ كِبَارِ السِّينِ, and those who are above us and our elders in age. Huraqal, after this dialogue, mukhtasaran, he began to repeat everything that Abu Sufyan, he said to him. And he said that all of these things that you told me about this individual, all of these things that I mentioned to you and I asked you about this individual, he said, wallahi, he said, by Allah, he said, if, ana akhlisu ilayhi latajashamtu ilayhi, if I was able to leave my throne, if I was able to leave my position, if I was able to go to him, I would exert all efforts, crossing the desert, crossing the lands to reach this man. وإني لغسلت عن قدمي. And indeed, I will wash from the water that this individual uses to wash his feet from. عظيم الروم كافر بالله مشرك بالله إله in the nas. This individual was a disbeliever. This individual was a mushrik. This individual was taken as an ilah amongst his people. This is what he said about our messenger, your messenger, who I believe in, who you believe in, who you claim to follow, who I claim to follow. This was the awe that he had after what? After understanding and being given knowledge of the characteristics and the qualities and the behavior and the mannerism and the call and the risala and the aqidah of this messenger. He said this about our messenger. What about us? After being people of Iman, after being people who claim to be Sunni, followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his sunnah, what is our love for the Messenger of Allah? What is our respect for the Messenger of Allah? Do we feel that if the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam was upon us now, we were washed from the water that he used to wash his feet, as the companion used to drink the water, his wadu, the water from his wudu. They used to drink the water from his wudu. They would do everything to get near to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, to take from his sweat. As Sulaim radiallahu ta'ala anha used to have a blanket in her home in which the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, he used to lay upon and he used to take naps and he would sweat on his blanket. And when he had passed away and he would leave in his lifetime and after his death, she used to take from this. And she used to take the sweat of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam as a perfume for herself and those who would come to get that from her. Ibadullah ayyuhal ikhwa wal akhwat. What is our relationship? What is our commitment? What is our love for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Harakal, he asked the question, is there anyone from amongst those who believe in him, after believing in him, leave away from his religion? He said, no one. Al-Fa'idah, the benefit that we extract from this statement is that, brothers and sisters, in many cases, we look at the individuals, we look at the people who are abandoning Islam, we look at the people who are leaving Islam from amongst us, we look at the people who are denying the sunnah amongst us, we look at the people who are denying the aqidah amongst us, we look at the people who are seeming to be those who are negligent in their adherence to Islam and their following of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but in actuality, they are negligent, they are leaving, they are abandoning, and they are rejecting what they see in us. Because wallahi, if they saw in us the true characteristics and the true imitation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, never would they reject what we have for them. Never would they reject the message that we bring to them. Never would they reject the advice that we are giving them. They are abandoning us. They are not abandoning that which Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was upon, because that which he was upon was pure and no one would enter into it and then exit from it after really tasting the halawa of Iman. أقول قولي هذا استغفر لي ولكم استغفر لي ولكم فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضاه، وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده وعبد ربه حتى أتاه اليقين من ربه، وصلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters in Al-Islam, في دراسة سيرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هي الميزان الذي توزن به الأعمال. In studying the seerah of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, number one, it is that scale. It is that which all of the actions that an individual does are compared, are weighed, are placed on that scale. There's no need to have so much confusion about if this is bid'ah or if this is sunnah. If this is aqidatu sahiha or aqidatu batila wa saqima. If this is correct aqidah or this is false aqidah, sick aqidah, corrupt aqidah. There's no reason that we have to have ikhtilaf about this. There's no reason that we have to have ikhtilaf about those who are causing fasad in the ard, causing fasad in the lands, bismil Islam, in the name of Islam, that they are khawarij. Udrus as-sira. Study the seerah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa ashabahu and his companions, and you will realize that these people, they are people who are dogs of the hellfire. Kama qala an-nabiy sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is no need to have ikhtilaf whether the rawafid or the rafida, khabitha, the people who curse our mother Aisha and speak ill of the companions and change the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of his Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam outside of the fold of Islam. Iqra al-seerah, read the seerah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wal ahadith al-sahiha. And this will tell you, and this is the balance, this is the scales. There's no need to have ikhtilaf whether the fact whether we should stick clearly and closely to the manhaj of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam aqidatan, ibadatan, akhlaqan, sulukan. There's no need for us to differ about that. Iqra al-seerah. Al-seerah hiya al-mizan alladhi tuzanu bihi ala amal. It is that scale that weighs all actions that a person is upon. Whether he's upon the sunnah or he's not. Whether his aqidah is correct or whether it is not. Because whatever agrees with that kana maqbula, then it is that which is that is accepted. And whatever disagrees with that kana marduda, it is rejected. Kama qala ummina Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala an ummuna Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha an hadith ar-rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam man ahdatha fi amrina hadha ma laysa minhu fa huwa rad wa man amila amalan laysa alayhi amruna fa huwa rad. That whoever does an affair that is not from our affair, it will be rejected. As-seerah barakallahu feekum, brothers and sisters. Taj'alu bayna yaday al-insan suratan mathilatan lil-qudwa al-hasana. That the seerah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it places in front of the person. It places at your hands. It places right in front of you an image, a practical example, a methodology, a qudwa hasana, a good example for you to follow. لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُوا اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. That in the Messenger of Allah, for you, for me, is the best example to follow. Anyone who you look up to, anyone who you respect, مِنْ أَهْلِ الْإِلْمِ مِنْ مَشَيْخِنَا, from amongst our scholars, from our ulama, from our shuyukh, from our teachers, whoever it may be, they're still not to be those whom every single statement they make is to be taken without any type of restriction whatsoever. But rather the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, everything that he has said from the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to be taken unrestrictedly. بدراسة سيرة الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم عون على فهم كتاب الله تبارك وتعالى والأمل به لأنه كان خلقه أيش؟ القرآن. In studying the seerah of the Messenger of Allah, it does what? It is an aid, it is a support to allow you to do what? So that we don't go astray in our understanding. It allows you and gives you aid and support to understand the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No understanding Quran barakallahu feekum without sunnah. No understanding Quran or just taking from Quran when we don't take hadith. No, just taking from the ayat of the book of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, and I don't need to follow that which is in the hadith, brother. We don't trust that. Ikhwan, this is 2016. We're not in the 70s anymore. So in understanding the seerah, which is the hadith, it allows you to understand the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because his character, his behavior, his actions, all of them was what? Al-Quran. كما قالت عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها حين سئلت عن خلق النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قالت خلقه القرآن كان خلقه القرآن. When Aisha was asked about the character of the Messenger of Allah, what did she say? His character is القرآن. وبدراسة سيرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, not only does it allow us to understand the Quran, the Sunnah, تفسير القرآن وتبينه وتعبر عنه. The Sunnah explains the Quran. The Sunnah is the tafsir of the Quran. And then thalithan, in sequential order of that, at-ta'arruf ala al-jil al-azim. Becoming acquainted with a very noble, a very great generation. Ishwa, he is sahaba. And they are the companions. Mawaqifuhum, mawaqifihim. Their stances, their positions concerning following the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa iftida'ihim, iftida'ihim, bimalihim, wa anfusihim. And their suffering, their sacrificing, their ransoming, their lives and their wealth for the Messenger of Allah and the deen of Islam that he was upon. Wa bidirasati siratin nabiyyi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tazidu mahabbatun nabiyyi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa huwa ahim shaykh. And in studying the seerah of the Messenger of Allah, it does what? It increases in us the love of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Because now you know how your Messenger was. Now you know how he was as a human being, as a man, as a father. كيف كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في بيته? How was the Messenger of Allah in his home? كيف كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم in the أصحابه? مع أصحابه. How was the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he was up amongst his companions? كيف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كيف معاملته للناس? How was the interaction of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How did he interact with the people? مسلميهم وكافريهم, the Muslims amongst them and the non-Muslims amongst them. How did he interact with them? These are the keys, these are the mafatih لنجاح دعوتنا وفلاح دعوتنا. These are the keys to the success of our da'wah. These are the keys to the prosperity of our da'wah. In understanding how the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was and who Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was. وبدراسة سيرة النبي sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And in understanding and studying the seerah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أخيرا عونا لفهم الدين كله. عونا لفهم الدين كله. It is that which will aid you and support you in understanding the entire religion. Understanding the entire religion. لأن بسيرة رسول الله في سيرة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم المنهج العظيم لحياة المسلمين. In the seerah of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, there lies within it the greatest blueprint, the greatest methodology, the greatest direction in the life of the Muslim. If the Muslim, فَمَنْ يُرِيدُ الْخَيْرِ فِي حَيَاتِهِ الدُّنْيَوِيَّةِ وَالدِّينِيَّةِ. For the one who wants happiness, for the one who wants satisfaction in the life of this world and ultimately in the hereafter. Brothers and sisters, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who understand and who have knowledge of and recognition of the superior qualities of our Messenger alayhi salatu wa salam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who are counted as the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam haqqan, fi'lan. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who drink from the hold of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us mukhlisin, to make us muhsinin, to make us muttaqin. Innama yataqabbalu Allahu min al-muttaqin. Allahu tabaraka wa ta'ala, he only accepts from the people of taqwa. We ask Allahu tabaraka wa ta'ala to grant us jannah, to grant us al-firdaus, to save us from his punishment, to save us from his hellfire, to resurrect us and raise us up amongst those who are min al-nabiyyin wa siddiqin wa shuhada'i wa salihin wa hasuna ulaika rafiqa. Hada wallahu a'lam wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barik ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa akhiru da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen wa aqimis salah.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. أشهد أن لا إله